Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So it is finally here, officially launched today, Valiant Force 2. Actually, I already played this game, the beta version, and the name was Project V. This one is a tactic SRPG, and since the Alchemist code already got its end of service, I think if you still want to play another tactic game, the new one, the new good one, this one could be the one. So let's dive in. Okay, so here we go. So this is the tutorial story. Just going to skip this. Oh yeah, we can skip the tutorial. That's nice. Okay, so here we go. Yep, this is exactly the same as the one on the beta version last time, which is the Project V. Yeah, as a tactic SRPG, this one has a really nice graphic. Yep. And the character design is also quite good. Yep. Extra attack. So touch the enemy. Okay. And then the character will be automatically moved to the enemy. And there are 5 elements. Okay, so 30% more damage to the weaker element, and dark and light 30% to each element. Okay, okay, confirm. Oh yeah. Enemy turn. Ally turn. Tap to move Felix here. Okay. Tap the skill icon. Ooh, nice AoE. And the animation is cool. Look at that. To the anime animation. Okay, finally, the home screen. Summon. Okay, the first summon, guys. One summon. Yeah, the animation is the same as the one on the beta. Okay. Well, nice summoning animation, I think. Okay. Melody. Oh, I think this one is fixed. Yeah, we'll definitely get this character, if I'm not wrong. Each hero has an aura that can be triggered under the right condition to inspire allies to perform special abilities in battle. Tap on Felix icon to learn more about his aura. Felix aura grants this benefit to linked units in the formation. A unit is linked when position is an adjacent tile, when an aura bearing is pointing to. Okay. Tap here. If the color of an aura bearing matches the color of the linked ally's aura trigger, a combo has been set up. Okay, let's add Melody to this squad next. Okay, tap here, confirm. Use the carousel lineup to quickly locate and select a unit to act in the battle is taking place over a large area. So rather than finding the character in the map, we can basically tap the character's icon on the bottom left. Then we can tap the enemy so that the character moves to that enemy and then press confirm to attack. Alright, pay attention to the terrain and avoid occupying tiles that might hurt or weaken your units. Okay. Okay, heal. Let's heal. Good as new. When auras are triggered, they inspire linked allies to take special action in battle. Tap this icon to learn more about this unit's aura. Okay. 50% chance when this unit is granted above the trigger. And skill effect, trigger all units causing linked units to attack an enemy unit within range dealing 12% damage. Tap on this tile to move at least into this position. Active skill. And then let's use it to the boss. Confirm. Okay, cool animation. Yeah. This animation is actually one of those things that I liked about this game. cool animation, good 3D graphic. The storytelling is also quite good actually, but I always skip the story. Okay, victory. Level up. Okay, so to level up the character, we can use this item. Nice, loving this. At least this is not another idle games. There are so many idle RPGs out there in the Play Store at this moment. Glad this one is not idle RPG. So tap on the icon of the gear to select it. So that is basically gear system, the equipment system in this game. Here we can see the red line from the enemy. It means that if we are staying in this position, the enemy will attack us. Well, that's quite convenient actually. So we have 6 classes here in this game: Guardian, Champion, Shadow, Mystic, Healer, and Ranger. There are 2 types of damage: physical damage and magical damage. The type of damage a unit deals is often determined by the unit class. So Guardian, Champion, and Ranger are physical damage. Shadow, Mystic, and Healer are magic damage basically. The Shadow looks like a thief class, but okay, magic damage. Interesting. Physical and magical. When you deal physical damage to a target, it will be reduced by the target's physical defense, and magical damage will be reduced by the target's magical defense instead. Quite common on every RPG, I think. Okay, so there is milestone here. If we completed all of these, we will get the free SSR hero Jenny. And yeah, the server is still unstable at this moment because of, as usual, the first day launch. I don't think the server is kinda capable enough to handle all of these new players' invasion. Okay, since when I try to open the mail, it's always disconnecting and I cannot reconnect, so let's just try to press summon to do my very first summon in this game. So the SSR rate in this game is 3%. Kinda makes sense. If it's truly 3%, it means in average of 33 pulls, we will get 1 SSR, and I think that's quite reasonable. And if you do it on a rate up banner, basically if you get an SSR, 50% chance to get the rated up character and 50% chance to get off banner character. So the rated up banner is actually having a really high rate for the rated up character. That's actually nice. So there are 3 banners at this moment. This one is the rated up banner for Madeleine, and the second banner is basically a step up banner, which we can get Cybella's Aetherite. Aetherite is the item that we need to promote the character. Okay, so I think I will do it here on the Madeleine summon. Who knows, I will be able to get this character. Madeleine. 3000 gems every 10 summon. Let's go. Who knows, I will be very lucky to get an SSR on my first 10 pull. Anyway, if I cannot get any SSR here, I think I'm just going to reroll. Alright, wow, 2 purples. Are these purple going to be SSR? No, I think just an SR. Okay, anyway, let's skip this. Yeah, just SR. So why don't we do single pulls? If still no SSR, then I'm just going to reroll. Okay, 1 pull, skip. Just an R character. Summon again. Okay, skip again. SR. Oh, SR healer. Then another one. Whoa! Wait! I actually got the rated up character with single pull. Nice! So if you want to reroll, basically press here on the menu on the bottom right, setting, then go to account, press account, and then you should press logout. So once you press logout, you will be on the title screen. In this game, once you actually use a guest account, even if you press logout, once you log in with guest account again, you will be back on your first guest account. So what you should do is log in with another account such as Google or Facebook. Use multiple emails to reroll. If you don't have that many emails, then the other thing that you can do is play it on emulator. Create multiple instances of emulator and just download Valiant for 2 on each emulator and then play them with synchronized feature so that you only need to play one account and then the other accounts will also get completed the tutorial. Press the gacha and then see the result. If you still cannot get the character you want, then just simply delete the emulator and then start a new emulator. That easy. So I think that's all for the first impression video for this Valiant Force 2. Definitely going to continue playing this game because I really like the genre, which is tactical SRPG, and it is actually on a very right timing when the Alchemist code just got its end of service. So this game could be the next the Alchemist code for me. Yeah, so see you again on the next video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe now if you haven't for more Valiant Force 2 video, and see you again next time. Bye, Ushi Punch.